We are created beings, finite beings with limitations, beings of need and beings of love. We fight for justice yet receive none. We seek peace, but peace is nowhere to be found. We discredit ourselves in saying that we are no good. We find shelter, yet the storm rages on within us. We seek but do not find, because we seek in the wrong places. O Heavenly Father, let these people come to the understanding that if they seek you with all their heart, they will find you. At the end of each God-given day, we find ourselves in the place where we were the previous night, pondering upon life, believing in all sorts only to get some rest. Yet true rest is out of reach, because we haven't truly examined ourselves to know that we need a Saviour. We may know it, but we push it aside like a thorn in the flesh. Then the day comes to an end and we are doing nothing but looking back on a wasted life. Do you want to be this person? Do you want to reach the end of your life and find nothing but sorrow? Because you ignored the inner voice telling you that you are more than just a mortal being. You had a purpose, but you listened to a multitude of voices telling you that you were not important. I'm here to remind you that you are important. You do have a purpose and that you are loved unconditionally. If you don't feel it, then seek it, but seek it correctly. Jesus Christ says, "Him that cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out." And again it says, "And ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your heart." There is hope for you, but the hope, the true hope that is everlasting, comes from Jesus Christ alone. You cannot take materialism to the grave. You will stand bare, naked in front of God. This is where there will be two types of people. Those who stand in front of God the Father, and all he sees is his only begotten Son in you. And those who stand in front of God, and all he sees is nothing but a willing rejection to trust in his only begotten Son. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. But that when they knew God, they glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened. You know within your own heart that you are not here by accident, but instead you have a purpose, that purpose being to come and know your Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ.